The college basketball season begins tonight, and from Brooklyn, New York, we welcome you to the Barclays Center Classic presented by Sheetz. And as the new season tips off, John Calipari's defending national champs are ready to find out, is Kentucky good enough to repeat?
What's happening here has never happened in college basketball.
I'm building an empire. I'm building it with all I know.
We're the only team that does not have a player coming back that started a game.
I'm building an empire.
I hope we're as good as everybody thinks we are, or there's going to be consequences. These kids all need me in different ways. I want to play with the best. I want to win championships. I don't have any fear. All I got to do is coach my team.
Tonight's game is part of ESPN's Journey to the Tourney, a season-long spotlight on games that impact the tournament. And in this one against Maryland, John Calipari brings another tremendous recruiting class. Kentucky is very young, but again, very, very talented as the Wildcats launch their quest for back-to-back NCAA titles. Great to have you with us tonight. It's a brand new season in a brand new arena here in Brooklyn, New York. Dave O'Brien, Dickie V, can't wait to get started. The Hall of Famer raring to go. Dick, let's let the games begin.
I'll tell you one thing. The big question tonight is, what will the new look Kentucky team look like? They lost all those starters that went to the NBA, six players. The bottom line is they lost the player of the year, Anthony Davis. How do they reload?
Well, they have an amazing capacity to do that. But as we look at their starting lineup, as you mentioned, all five faces are new in the starting lineup from the last time we saw them in a national title game. Now, Kyle Wiltjer played in every game last season, but he never started one. Archie Goodwin, Alex Poythress, and Nerlens Noel are all freshmen. Noel, the top recruit in America. And Dick, in our one-on-one, what do you spotlight tonight?
Well, you got to spotlight Noel because basketball efficiency starts in the three-second area. He's a shot blocker deluxe, but he doesn't have the offensive skills of Anthony Davis. So I don't want to hear about those comparisons. They are totally unique players, different in every way. They block shots, but Davis was able to score as well. Bottom line is, Noel can create a havoc to defenses. He is unbelievable on the defensive end. People can't get to the rim against Kentucky with him.
For Maryland, the starting lineup now, the Terps are also young, but Des Wells, who transferred from Xavier, has big-time experience. Nick Faust is a big guard. He's 6'6". Alex Len is a seven-footer from Europe. He's really going to be counted on tonight against Kentucky size. Maryland will play a lot of freshmen and sophomores, and Dick Wells should be the Terps' best player.
Well, when we're talking about Wells, he's an explosive athlete. Came the way of Xavier, was just recently declared eligible. Santa Claus arrived very early for Mark Turgeon and the Terps. This is going to be a quality basketball team, Maryland. Tonight is not Cupcake City, baby.
Kentucky, the eighth youngest team in the nation last year, but still won the national championship, their eighth title. The Terps did not earn a postseason spot. They finished at 17-15, eighth in the ACC, 6-10 in the conference. They have an excellent recruiting class, however, ranked very high by ESPN. And John Calipari now in his fourth year at Kentucky, his 20th year overall. Of course, he briefly coached the New Jersey Nets in the 1990s. Now the Brooklyn Nets here in this great new arena, which is drawing raves. Very stylish building.
It is really beautiful. Jay-Z's in the house as well.
Came over to say hello to Dick Vitale before the game.
I told him, where's Beyonce, baby?
Don't we all say that?
I saw Beyonce in concert. She is unbelievable.
Now Jay-Z, in fact, opened this building with eight nights of performances starting back in late September, and we are ready to go. Maryland in the gray. Those are full wool uniforms to salute the old Brooklyn Dodgers, who played right up the road just a couple miles away. And we are set for the opening tip here in Brooklyn, and Kentucky wins it.
Key for Kentucky to be the point guard play of Ryan Harrell. They've had so many good point guards over the years. He has the pressure and has to really get them in their offensive sets.
Goodwin back out to Harrell, who's battling flu-like symptoms. There was some question about whether he would start in this one. Back to Goodwin, very talented youngster. Inside Noel with the first shot of the season for Kentucky.
That's the way to start for a diaper dandy. Got the ball inside, went over the left shoulder, right to the basket.
Wells, who is out of Raleigh, North Carolina, gives it up. The corner jumper for Howard won't go. And tip deep, and a great effort on the save attempt by Kentucky. That was Goodwin sailing out of bounds into his own bench, giving a great early effort. But we're going to have a lot of looks tonight at that young man. Nerlens Noel, the 6'10 freshman.
They go right inside. Here he is working with a little jump hook in the lane. He can utilize either hand effectively inside.
Calipari has had so many great big guys slashing inside. Terrific move by Faust, but can't get it to go. It's going to be tough sledding inside against Kentucky again.
You know, Dave, you're exactly right. Very difficult on the interior.
Goodwin on a drive, and he is fouled by Des Wells.
He's an explosive transition player, Archie Goodwin. He can really get from one end of the floor to the other quickly. John Calipari, Jones, he's a mini version of Russell Westbrook.
The coaches rave about him, a freak athlete, lockdown defender, freshman out of Little Rock, Arkansas. He was the Arkansas Gatorade Player of the Year, Mr. Basketball, McDonald's All-American. He did everything.
He's going to really have to work on his perimeter shot. People are going to play off him because he has that great first step, and he's so explosive to the basket. A little full-court pressure on Maryland.
Keyshawn Howard, he's a junior, some experience there for Mark Turgeon.
He missed 18 games last year. A little knee problem. Can't get the ball there. See, can't get to the rim. That's what we're talking about.
Faust and a foul on the play with 18:45 to go here in the first half. Noel just came up with his first rejection before that.
See, I think it's really important for teams to be able to make the 15 to 17 foot jump shot. You got to make some jump shots against Kentucky because you're not getting in the lane. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane. The first commandment of Mr. Noel in basketball.
The three shots here for Faust, however, fouled in the act of shooting a three by Harrell, who picked up his first personal.
Faust came on strong at the end of the year. Last nine games, that was like 13 points a game. Mike Krzyzewski told me the other day on the phone how he really likes this kid. Very athletic, very tenacious player. Maryland's got some good quality players. He was an all-ACC freshman team last year, had 19 against Wake in the tournament.
Well, he's a guy that Mark Turgeon had to convince to stay after Gary Williams left the program when he retired. Second effort, Faust outside the three. On the dribble drive, trying to slice in. Here's Len off the iron, up the backboard very high. Did not touch the iron. Here's Wiltjer to line it up. That's his shot, but he can't knock it down.
He really is a great perimeter shooter for a big player. He has to add other points to his game. He's got to defend a lot better, and he's got to be able to rebound a lot better.
But he's a real matchup problem, isn't he?
Yeah, he really is, because of the size.
Wiltjer from Portland, Oregon at 6'10".
His dad was quite a player. Played at Oregon State.
Faust, here's Wells to size one up and can't knock it down. The three-pointer won't go. Kentucky wants to run. Harrell will back it out now. Smart decision there, 2 minutes in. Wiltjer up top, Noel to drive to his left. Tough move, stumbled a bit, no whistle. Now Wells with a nifty bounce, partially deflected. Underneath the spin move, Padgett, and he draws the foul. James Padgett, who's a Brooklyn native.
They played high school here on the Lincoln High School. He's a good offensive rebounder, really gets to the glass. And Padgett and guys like, when you talk about Becker and Faust and Howard, they got some good experience. And now you throw in the superstar, Wells, they're going to win their share of games.
Poythress with the foul. Maryland has not made a shot from the field yet. They're 0 for 5. And Padgett to the line. He told us at Shuron today, he used to walk past the area that Barclays Center was built on and go shopping at a local mall here just a couple of hundred yards away. When he was in school, he said, I never dreamed there would be an arena in this place, he said, let alone that I would play in it as a senior.
Tell you one thing, I haven't been to Brooklyn in years. Last time I was here was to recruit Phil Sellers at Rutgers University. When I was at Rutgers, and man, that is a long time. That's the early 70s. You weren't even born. And then prior to that, the last time I was here, to see Don Newcomb pitch and Jackie Robinson, Ebbets Field, and
you do go back.
Oh, the Happy Felton's gang, man. The Nuthole gang. Just to love him.
Wiltjer up ahead for Goodwin. They break the Maryland pressure on the spin move, taken away by Wells. He can really handle the ball. He can do so many things well for the Terps. Faust, long one coming. That one missed ugly.
That was Brick City, USA. Goodwin has a little tendency to play a little bit out of control. He's going to make that jump shot, Wiltjer.
Leaning in, that's going to be an offensive foul. Number two on Poythress, the freshman from Clarksville, Tennessee.
You never really expect the big things out of Poythress. So highly rated, terrific rebounder, an athlete, guy that can step out as well, attack the rim. He was attacked in the basket, good defensive play. You know, Mark Turgeon played at Kansas, and one of the young assistants at that time for Larry Brown was a guy named Calipari. And I asked Mark, I said, what was he like? He said he hasn't changed. He's screaming, yelling, play defense, then, and he's doing it now.
That's going to be an offensive foul, 17:06 to go here, and that one will go against Padgett. That'll be James first.
You know, Dave, you're going to see sloppy play early. I mean, you're looking at a team here in Kentucky with all new players, getting familiar with one another, developing a rhythm. I'm going to tell you something. You better beat Kentucky now. Because in the middle of the year, better. They're going to get better and better and better.
All five starters drafted in the NBA. Six players off the Wildcats championship team drafted, and that's going to be an offensive on Wiltjer.
He ducked in that shoulder. They got a date Tuesday night over that championship class, Michigan State, Kansas. And then we'll have Kentucky and Duke.
A great way for us to get the season started. Marvelous game from Germany, which we had for you on ESPN right before ours.
Tell you, all-time wins. Kentucky leads the pack. Unbelievable, followed by Kansas, North Carolina, and Duke.
Great catch. Look at Len on the spin. Boy, he can do some things in close.
He's gotten stronger. They say he really came in with a lot more confidence. Alex Len is a key player for him.
Oh, Goodwin got the shot to go. And he'll go to the line for a three-point attempt.
He's a guy who really gets to the basket. Just like Westbrook does. They really attack the rim. Westbrook was played at UCLA. Here he is right there. Good body control. Now he's looking up there. Go down. Go down, he's saying. He's going to be tough for people to defend with his quickness. McDonald's All-American, as you can see. Everybody there is an All-American. Everybody's an All-American.
Lehman with the foul. He wasn't the only one that got a piece of Goodwin.
McDonald's.
Got the roll.
I want some Wendy's All-Americans, too.
Kentucky, 7-5 lead. Goodwin now with 5 points, so a nice start for the freshman.
Playing defense is a must if you're going to play for John Calipari in Kentucky.
Len on Noel, moving to his right, and draws the foul. 16-15 to go. This is a pretty good battle between these two bigs.
You know, it's really smart by right there, Alex Len, trying to take the ball right at the shot blocker. I love that hairdo, man. I like anybody's hairdo. I just wish I had some hair.
That's a big-time flat top. Harrell picked up his second foul there as Len knocks it down. This is an issue for Maryland. They need to improve on their foul shooting in a big way if they're going to be really competitive. Just 66% last year.
Yeah, they didn't shoot well on that free throw line. You know, he came in a tough situation. He placed a legend. The floor is named after Gary, and deservedly so, Gary Williams. He was left. Jordan Williams went to the NBA, and it was really a patched-up kind of club, and he scrapped and clawed to win 17 games. This team, he told me before the game, he said, Dick, we're deeper, we're much more talented, and he thinks we're going to have really a good year. And I'm going to tell you, the future is bright.
Polson into the game, running the point now. He appeared in just 11 games last year for Kentucky.
They got to really attack him because he's limited in experience. He's a kid that's really worked hard in practice.
Lehman with the rebound. Maryland very high on him. He's a great athlete out of Wrentham, Massachusetts. And coming to the Maryland program, their recruiting is really picked up. Faust lets fly. Can't hit it off the back iron. And a scrap for the rebound. It goes to the Wildcats. They want to run a bit.
You know, one little concern if you're Kentucky is depth factor. Two players down with two fouls.
Noel with the left hand. Very well defended in the paint.
See, he's got to spin there. He's got to dunk that.
Great look by Howard and Len. Oh, on the topic of dunks.
Yeah, Mr. Len says, hey, Noel, you don't want to dunk it? I'm going to dunk it on the other end. They're jumping with joy a little bit right now down at College Park, Maryland.
Indeed, Maryland jumps into the lead 9-7. There are a lot of Terps fans in this building tonight. They're starting to get loud, too. Mays slipped on a basketball and a kickball there. It's going to go the other way. 9-7 Maryland and a timeout.
No, I think we're going to see Goodwin play some point guard. Oh, take a look right here. Mr. Len, he's from the Ukraine. There he is, little Jam City.
Now the route to NBA stardom certainly through Kentucky. Look at all the players, 15 total drafted over the last 3 years.
I think one game, I remember coaching, if you had a first rounder, you'd be excited. He had 11 first rounders his first 3 years. And 4 second rounders. And the second rounders have all made rosters. Darius Miller, the kid Lamb, Harrelson. They've all made a roster. Liggins, they're all on clubs. That's 15 guys. Unbelievable what he's achieved. Jay Billis said it the other day. He and I were doing a conference call. He said the 3 years is probably the most amazing 3 years that he's ever witnessed. And I say amen to that because it's unbelievable. And remember, the one and done, he didn't make the rule. He is just right now applying use of the rule.
Trying to get it inside to a Shaq, Shaquille Clear, big freshman out of the Bahamas. And Kentucky commits the foul. That'll be on Wiltjer. And his second. 6th team foul for Kentucky.
They just brought in the 7-footer, Willie Cauley. Stein, they're really excited about him. They think that he has got quite a future.
He wears number 15 in white. These are new uniforms for Kentucky, too. And they have 8 stars on the back, up around the shoulder blades, to represent the 8 national championships that they have won. And that foul will go the other way. Offensive foul against Maryland.
I see one area where I think Kentucky's going to have guys have to step up, and that's making that perimeter shot, the 3-point shot. May should be able to do that, a transfer from out of Wright State, and Wiltjer must do it, because if he's not making threes, he then doesn't become a major factor, because in the other areas, he has a lot of work to do when you talk defense and rebound.
May's an outstanding 3-point shooter. How about the step by Goodwin? He draws the foul on his way to the basket.
He's an attacker. He's a guy that sees a seam, sees a gap, and he's going to attack it off the bounce and try to get right to that rim.
He led Sylvan Hills High School in Arkansas to the state championship last March. Calipari has compared him to Tyreek Evans. Of course, start for him in Memphis.
You know, I'm glad you just mentioned the name Evans. Think about the point guard play. I'm trying to remember this now mentally here. But you think about the point guard play they've had. From Derrick Rose, when he was at Memphis, Calipari had him. Tyreek Evans. Then he has a guy named John Wall. A guy named Brandon Knight. Marcus Teague. What do you all have in common? All first-round draft choices. That puts a lot of pressure on a guy like Ryan Harrell at that point guard club. Because the scrutiny is unbelievable at the point guard slot for Kentucky, just like the quarterback position at Notre Dame.
Lehman missing badly off the backboard. 14-11 to go here in the first half, tied at 9. Dick, top 5 NBA draft picks, coached by Calipari.
It's a pretty good roster right there. You have a pretty good team with that club.
Indeed.
Anthony Davis is going to be so special. They are so fortunate, the Hornets, to get him. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is a warrior. He's a winner. He just has to make shots a little better.
Well, Mitchell got a good look, but Maryland is just 2-for-11 shooting it. Mays at the foul line, little bump there. Goodwin, another spin, wriggling inside, and he'll draw the whistle at 14:01 to go.
He's going to put a lot of points on the board. He's a scorer. He's a slasher. See Albert King to my right, relaxing here, played over here in high school in Brooklyn, was a superstar with the Terps at Maryland.
Man, could he score.
He can flat out score. His brother wasn't too bad either. The Bernie and Ernie show down in Tennessee.
A good one at the line.
great to be back, man. Dave, great to be back. I mean, I can't, I'm a little kid, and I'm so excited. It's like the first day of school.
Now, what do you do all summer? I know you go to baseball games. You're a big baseball fan. You go to see the Rays play.
I go to a lot of concerts, too. I love music. For my guy, Kenny Chesney, right down the line. I love all kinds of music. I love to see Beyonce, Jay-Z's lady.
On that topic, there are a lot of great shows right here scheduled in the brand new Barclays Center over the next several months. As that one is deflected out of bounds, Barbara Streisand's going to be here. Lady Gaga's going to be here.
Wow, I got to come and see Barbara. Get me some tickets.
Rihanna, Justin Bieber, who I know you adore, is going to be here as well.
Barbara went to high school with a great player by the name of Billy Cunningham at Erasmus High School.
Yes. Turnover. Here comes Mays on the drive to the left hand. Nicely done.
They really expect him to be a real major contributor. He was a guy who came over, transferred, graduated Wright State. Got the extra year. He said he's getting used to all the screaming and yelling. He said, I never had to deal with this, but I love it. I love it. And he can make shots. He can make the three.
Offensive foul here against Maryland. Let's go back to that drive by Mays, who can also drain the three.
Yeah, we're going to see him right here in transition. He's going to protect the ball really well, seals off the defense, lays it up with the left hand. There's a lot of controversy among coaches about that transfer rule where a kid stays with you 3-4 years, then he leaves because he says he's going to graduate school. A lot of people really wonder about that. Coach said we bust our gut with a kid for 3-4 years, and then he's gone, rather than stay and do graduate work where they're at.
Mays thought about a three. Wells came out quickly on him. Here's Cauley-Stein. Nice give. Polson wriggles in for two.
Nice little two-man play. Calipari's going to be happy with that. Nice pass. The entry to the big guy. They say she's got, he was a heck of a football player.
Faust inside, tipped away, and a foul here with 12:53 to go.
Tell you one thing, got that size on the floor. When you look at Willie Cauley-Stein, along Stein rather, along with Noel, look at that size. And there's a nice little pass to Polson. Little simple play. Cut, move without the ball, right down the lane. Kentucky on a little run right now, 7-0.
So Faust at the line. Noel committed the foul. So he's there for two.
See, the one thing that'll help this Kentucky team, last year was a stronger group of teams. I mean, it was deeper with quality teams than really I believe there are. I think there are a lot of teams that are certainly beatable out there. And that's going to play right into the hands of these Kentucky kids, because I really think this group of kids, if they were playing last year, it might be a little tough when you talk about being a top 10 team.
Well, two consecutive trips to the Final Four for Kentucky. They open up in the very first poll of the young college basketball season as the number three team in the country. Maryland trying to trap them again. Cauley-Stein got it across, almost stepped over.
He's very agile for a big guy.
Well, you talked about the fact that as a 7-footer, he runs so well. He was a wide receiver in high school, and he just terrorized defenses. How would you like to be a 5'9 defensive back going up against him at 7'1?
Wow.
Noel out of the double team. Polson on the drive. Shovels it. Cauley-Stein with the hook. No. Follows that miss and back up and in.
I'm going to tell you one thing. He's going to get a lot of playing time. He's going to get a lot of PT, baby. He's very agile for a big guy. Doesn't look fragile. He looks agile, mobile. Now he's going to get a little hostile.
Wells drawing contact as he's bumped on the shoulder. 12:04 left in the half. Hey, Tuesday on ESPN, it's the State Farm Champions Classic from the Georgia Dome at 7. Michigan State takes on Kansas. And then at 9 o'clock, the Duke Blue Devils face Kentucky for the first time in 10 years. Tuesday, 7 to 9. On ESPN.
Okay, people want to go out early, find out a little bit about what Jeff Shepard and Christian Leitner are going to do to raise money before the game at a rally. These two guys are generous can be, got hearts of gold. They're going to be out there raising dollars for the V Foundation. Find out 4 to 6 o'clock before the game. I'm going to stop by and say hi to them all, and they're going to present me a check for the V Foundation.
Big check, and one that you don't get to keep, but gladly we'll give away, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Back to the V Foundation.
To help kids battling cancer. You know who's getting some quality minutes right here, more than I anticipated? to get with the ball, Polson.
Yes, he is.
I really am surprised all the minutes he's getting. He's given a solid little performance, too.
Former walk-on, now on scholarship for Kentucky.
See, though, as long as he doesn't turn the ball over and he gives him some minutes.
Mays, good look. Drops in a three.
We talked about it, Dave. He can make that three. He's a good three-point shooter, and that's something they need in their arsenal.
He made 42% at Wright State last year from three-point distance.
See, now spread the defense and allow a little bit more one-on-one maneuvers inside for the big players.
Wells trying to get started, off to Padgett, leaning in, denied by Kentucky. No chance there. Goodwin slashing in again. No.
Out of control.
Yes.
He has to learn to control himself. That shot had no chance.
Howard. And a foul to go the other way. This will go against Maryland. And a rebounding Frey. One of the ways to get here, take the subway. Many, many different ways of public transportation to get here to Brooklyn.
Hey, Albert. Where's King Albert? Albert should be on there, Albert. You should be. You know, should be there, Albert.
What about Bernard? That was good.
Bernard, what about Phil Sellers? He should be on there.
Everyone knows Brooklyn basketball is basketball.
Brooklyn basketball is super. You're looking great, man.
Thanks a lot.
You're looking super.
All the way.
They could use you, Albert.
Is this true that technically Michael Jordan was born in Brooklyn, New York?
Well, that's what people say. So they're going to claim Michael, too.
Got to put him on the list. Well, stars everywhere here tonight. It's a great night to be here at Barclays Center. It's a terrific, as we said, very stylish arena. Very unusual look to it. And it's a great, great place to see a basketball game. 18,000 here. Jay-Z is one of the many stars in the house tonight.
Also want to say, you know, I raised $1 million to Kentucky kids on behalf of the Hurricane Sandy victims. You know, a friend of mine, Helene and Richard, they lost their house up here in Breezy Point. Their sister also lost their house, Helene's sister. Our hearts go out to all those beautiful people.
Wells on the attack there, draws the foul, 11 minutes to go. Des Wells, Maryland's best player. They very nearly didn't have him tonight. He was dismissed from the Xavier team and school following a sexual assault allegation in which the prosecutor there in Ohio refused to bring charges. Now, he transferred to Maryland. Normally, that would require him to sit out 1 year. But Maryland went and tried to get the NCAA initially to waive that, and they said no. They appealed it, and just this week, the NCAA agreed with Maryland and allowed him to begin playing immediately.
Well, I think they made the right decision. I really do. And the NCAA, I've been critical of them because they're so inconsistent with their decisions on transfers. I'd really like to see a transfer rule change. I think if a coach agrees that a kid should transfer, that he's not getting any playing time, that kid should be allowed to play immediately. I mean, coaches move on, school after school. They don't sit a year. So why should a kid sit if a coach says, you know what, I think he should go somewhere else and play?
Mays gives up the dribble. Here's Cauley-Stein, the freshman from Kansas.
A little too much standing around Kentucky right now. Not getting enough player movement, ball movement. A little high screen for Wiltjer.
Shot clock at five. Wiltjer, nice shovel there. And how about Cauley-Stein to flush it down?
Good little instincts by Wiltjer right there to get it to the big guy. I'm telling you, I'm really impressed with Willie Cauley-Stein. I really am. He bothered that shot right there.
He did.
His size bothered that shot.
Glenn with the miss, another scramble. Faust off the fake to get inside the paint. Teardrop won't fall there. Tipped around, Maryland battling for it. Nice work done by Charles Mitchell. Wells on the baseline. A little bit out of control there. And Mitchell's traveling with it, so no basket.
They're gonna get some points out of guys like Faust and Howard. And certainly Wells is going to put some points on the board. Now watch the big guy. Good little look. There's the little handoff, and there's the jam by Willie Cauley-Stein. Nice little pass by Wiltshire. Good instincts right there. Gets the loose ball, flips it underhand.
Cauley-Stein caught 16 touchdown passes as a senior on the football field, so he has great hands.
They should go get him at Kentucky, play a little football, too. Be a dual guy. I feel bad for their coach. He got fired. Great guy, Joker Phillips. Now the job's open. There's a lot of controversy. Some are saying, hey, what about Bobby Petrino? You know, he's had a little bit of a shaky background on his resume, but he wins.
Goodwin with the miss. It comes to Polson for the jumper from 14.
They are getting solid minutes out of Polson, and that is a major plus.
They're getting a big performance out of their bench. Perry and Faust went for the stuff, but no, as he was denied by Cauley-Stein.
And that's size again, size.
On the other end, here's Wiltjer, left wide open. Got it, a three.
That's what he does. It does it best. A little run, and I'm a little excited right now. John Calipari said, relax, relax.
A 7-0 run. Kentucky up 26-14. Kentucky has opened up a 26-14 lead and doing it on both ends of the floor.
Well, the one thing they're going to do under John Calipari, they're going to get better and better as it. They play defense as a unit, as a team. And that size inside that you got to deal with is a nightmare. And this guy can make the long-range three. That's his great asset, shooting the perimeter shot. I'm going to tell you one thing. The surprise tonight has been Polson and Willie Cauley-Stein. They have really played so well.
And the Kentucky bench has outscored Maryland 13-0 here in the first half.
And Maryland has a pretty good bench. They got some quality players.
Faust with a miss. Glenn will keep it alive here. Keyshawn Howard denied there by Polson.
Howard having a tough time getting free for a shot.
Glenn on Cauley-Stein. Trying to spin away from him and gets the roll. Nice touch.
He's got some good offensive skills for a 7-footer.
He has 8 points. Alex Len from Ukraine. And a big one at 7-1.
Tell you, John Calipari really milking that play in time, getting the most out of Paulson. From the walk on, as you said earlier, Dave.
Poythress trying to wriggle in. Knocked right back in his face by Len. Nice denial there.
He's playing with two fouls right now, Poythress. Gotta let the game come to him. He's trying to force the action. Create things that aren't there. Nice backdoor cut.
To Faust for two. And now the timeout on the other side for Kentucky.
Nice little combination there. 45-degree angle. Drop the bounce pass like a dime. Nice little cut off the offside. Maryland well coached. Mark Turgeon's been a winner. He won at Wichita State. He won at Texas A&M. 4 years in a row for the tournament.
Len with the tough D, the block there, and now the back door.
Nice little backdoor cut from the weak side. Look opposite. Mark Turgeon is a fierce competitor, and he will absolutely make you play on the defensive end. And let me tell you, that's a tough act to follow when you go to replace Gary Williams.
Hey, after a dramatic comeback victory, the undefeated Irish will look to continue their quest for perfection against Boston College. It's Saturday Night Football presented by Windows 8. Number 4 Notre Dame taking on BC tomorrow at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC.
They find a way to win. They really do, the Fighting Irish.
They certainly did against Pitt in an absolute thriller.
Talk about a drama. I've been to a number of their games. As you know, my family is all Notre Dame. My two daughters, my sons-in-laws, 4 of them all graduates. I couldn't spell Notre Dame. I couldn't get in there. I was too dumb.
Cauley-Stein in a high post. Here's Harrell back in the game, running the point. Wiltjer driving it, airborne, yes, nicely done.
He should put points on the board for this. Now he's going to get a lot of minutes last year. Certainly, I thought they should have played him a little bit more. I used to get on John about that. I thought he should have got more minutes last year.
Len inside, again, Feathery touching close on this occasion.
Alex Len's going to be a quality player this year.
Wiltjer free. Yes, all net for a triple.
He feels it, man. He's got that great touch. Now he's got the bounce on the floor. Look at him bouncing up and down. He said, hey, Cats fans, look at me. And he's looking at Calipari. He says, see, coach, you didn't play me last year.
Well, he did play in every game, but Kentucky is the only BCS-level school in the country that does not have a player who started at least one game coming back.
Think about it, and being ranked in the top 5 in America, almost every poll, and you don't have one guy coming back.
That's a kickball off Cauley-Stein. Stops the clock with 7:02 remaining. Starting to put on a little bit of a shooting display right now is Kyle Wiltjer, the 6'10 sophomore from Portland, Oregon, lighting it up here in Brooklyn. Well, back inside the Barclays Center, we want to remind you that if you want to donate to the Red Cross to benefit the victims of Hurricane Sandy, right on the screen there, 1-800-RED-CROSS, or text RED CROSS to 90999 to donate $10. And how about earlier tonight, the Kentucky basketball program, the university, and John Calipari donating to the American Red Cross. That is a check for about $1 million to benefit those victims. What a wonderful gesture.
Yeah, really. And I think the one thing about New York, they're so resilient, all the people uniting together, doing all they can to help. And that's certainly, we look at John Calipari, I mean, the guy's a leader. There's no doubt about it. He can rally people, he can sell. People can criticize. I mean, if I put a tweet up, something positive, you can't believe the negative comments I get back. A lot of envy, a lot of jealousy.
Great move on the baseline by Wells. Des Wells for two.
That's his first basket for Wells. Bottom line, face reality. His greatest asset, we know he can recruit, but he can take superstar egos, kids that come in with big-time reputations, and get them to play for the name of that jersey on the front. And forget about worrying about shots, scoring. Perfect example last year, Davis and Kit Gilchrist. You ready for this? Those guys were number one and two in the draft in the NBA, and they were on the bottom two in shots taken at Kentucky. They could care less about the score. They cared about one thing, win, win. And that's what he does in a marvelous way. And that's a coaching ability, a coaching skill that he possesses.
Layman with the foul, Poythress at the line, a freshman from Clarksville, Tennessee. Selected to the preseason All-SEC team. Confident, very bright young man.
Tell you one thing, this Kentucky team, if this is any indication, looking at them defensively, look at those numbers. Look at those absolute numbers. And he makes certain that his kids, even if they're going to leave early, that they finish the year academically, they care. I was there to speak this summer at an event. I could not believe the unbelievable respect, and you could feel the love that the players have for their leader.
Maryland with the basketball here. And Des Wells, a sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina, went high and couldn't finish it. Wiltjer there for the rebound. He's doing a little of everything right now.
You know, Wells really having a little tough time right now. He just found out if he's going to be eligible. That's what he does best. Goodwin.
Right down the lane, as strong as you can be. And Kentucky's going to need that. They're going to need scoring from different places because they returned less than 7% of their scoring from last year. Shot by Allen. That won't fall. They're just not dropping tonight for Maryland, at least not here in the first half with 5:51 to go. They're 6 out of 26 there.
Yeah, Allen's certainly an explosive guy. He's a good guy off the bounce. But here goes Goodwin with that drive. See, I could see the comparison a little bit to a young version of Russell Westbrook. I mean, he was an attacker when he played at UCLA. Not able to make some threes. If you're going to beat Kentucky, you have to make some perimeter shots because you can't get to the rim that easily. You just can't with those big fellas inside.
In particular, when Noel is in the game, he's been on the bench for a while now, but Cauley-Stein, a 7-footer in his own right, has been the eraser in close for the Wildcats.
And all I could simply say, you better get Kentucky this year, because next year, ouch.
With that recruiting
ouch.
Class, yes.
Ouch.
Dropping it down low. Wiltjer working on left. Well, how about that give? Over the shoulder for 2 points. Poythress able to finish that one up, but that was a wonderful pass.
We have not seen the real Alex Poythress yet here tonight. Physical, strong. He could be a monster for them on the glass. He should be a terrific offensive rebounder.
Goodwin with a great effort, went sprawling into the backcourt, going after the ball, coming up on 5 minutes to go in the half. And that one knocked away by Cauley-Stein. That was supposed to be an alley-oop pass.
Tell you
and
what,
rejected.
It is unbelievable when you can take talent and get talent to play as a unit and have them play with intensity on a defensive end.
Who's looking for Len, who is camped right there on the other side of the iron, but it never got there. How about the effort? Maryland ball with 15 to shoot.
I'm really impressed. Kentucky has really impressed me more than what I anticipated tonight. I really mean that.
Maryland is yet to connect on a three-pointer. They're 0-for-8. Faust will try another one. And again a miss, 0-for-9.
Not really a good look at that three right there.
Faust with a bounce. Wells, yes, I should say, underneath the Padgett. He got the two.
Padgett right out of Lincoln High School here in Brooklyn, New York. Had some great moments last year. Strong on the offensive boards. I'm going to talk a little bit about the Kentucky class for next year.
On the turnover.
And a layup right here.
Faust will stuff it in off the feed from Allen. So now Maryland tightens it up a little bit. 37-26.
Look at the scrap. They got some good athletes. They got depth. And running into a team in his first half is really doing such a solid job defensively.
He's off the fake. Cauley-Stein banks in two.
I can't get over the way they're executing. And their half-court offensive set. I mean, this is November. Are you kidding me? And these are a bunch of new kids playing together.
Well, they've made 8 of their last 10 shots. Great move to his left by Allen. And the stuff by Lamb.
Nice drive. 3D man, baby. Drive, draw, dish. And dump that rock off. Look at Turgeon. Look at that intensity, emotion.
Seth Allen, who made that wonderful pass. He's just a freshman. He's going to play a lot. Very athletic guard with a 40-inch vertical.
They like their freshman kids, the Mitchells, the Laymans.
Yep.
Clear.
Wiltjer. They double up on him, and it's deflected out of bounds off Maryland with 3:27 to go in the half. And the Terps starting to climb back in. 39-28, Kentucky here at Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Well, coming up, UPS halftime report with John Digger and Seth. We have first half analysis, also highlights from Germany, and a game between Michigan State and UConn, which came right down the last couple of possessions.
Okay, one thing, Digger, look at that there. What a crew. Hey, I like Seth Greenberg up there because he's a member of my ball dome club. I think Seth's going to do a great job, a new addition. We got Bruce Pearl, another new addition. This guy's no basketball. And the lad to the unbelievable stable. I'm so proud to be a little spoke in that wheel. We got some unreal analysts. I think they're phenomenal.
And starting tonight, college basketball season is underway. And we come to you tonight from Brooklyn. And the first major college game played in this arena. There's another one by Wiltjer on target from three.
They better find him. They better find him. He comes as advertised, able to shoot that three. Some of the Terps have not been able to do. 0-for-9 thus far. Good perimeter defense by Kentucky.
Len, he's shown good touch in the first half. Padgett with the grab, rebound, up and in.
As we talked about a little bit earlier, how he's a really prolific offensive rebound. Rebounder, that was his strength last year for the Terps.
Maryland's getting a lot of offensive rebounds. They have 14 in the first half.
They've out-rebounded Kentucky.
But not a lot of second-chance points. They're not getting them to go on the second effort. Hayes will launch it. Got a good look, but off the front of the iron. Allen into the lane. Got airborne very early. Faust with the dribble. We're going to bank it up and in.
Tell you one thing, they play with a lot of confidence. I know they're down in the scoreboard, but right now it's down to 10. It was 15, was it not?
It was. Faust breaking into double figures.
I think psychologically that'd be big for Maryland. They get this to single digits at halftime.
Mays on the drive left open for two.
Nobody rotated over defensively. Take away the driving angle. Mays had a simple move to the goal.
Rare experience in this case, Dick, for them because of all the freshmen and sophomores that Calipari has. He's a graduate. Played for two colleges at both Wright State and NC State before coming. 1:46 to go as that one is swatted out of play. 44-32.
He was a traveling man. Marco Polo style. Don't like it here, I go there. Don't like it there, I go there.
Now Maryland to inbound.
You know, I told you I was going to talk about that Kentucky class. They were able to beat out Maryland, came down to Maryland and Kentucky for the Harrison twins from out of Texas. Both are incredible ability.
Wells with a miss. Knocked away from Poythress. They get it back. Inside Wells. Denied again. Lent over the shoulder. That won't fall. Now it's stuck. And it'll stay on this end, the possession arrow, with a minute 33 to go.
Ely attacking on the glass, going after it. You know, Harrison kid said, we're going to stay 4 years. I got a better chance at growing hair than ever remaining in Lexington for 4 years.
So choosing Kentucky over Maryland. On the bounce, here's Allen. That didn't touch anything, but Faust comes away with it.
There's another offensive rebound. They're beating Kentucky on the glass. John Calipari's not going to be happy with those numbers.
Maryland has just been awful from three-point land.
18 offensive rebounds.
Then swishes in a two-pointer. He can really shoot it out there.
He's got great skills. He does for a big guy.
Polson off to Goodwin. He'll let fly. And that one rattles in from three-point land.
If he can add that shot to his repertoire, his ability to get to the rim, he will be a prolific scorer.
He has 13. Underneath, how about the reverse there by Lynn? And that's a seven-footer.
He did the reverse and it protected the ball, got him a layup. Poor job by Kentucky in transition defensively.
Alex Lynn with 16 for Maryland. 47-36.
I'm surprised with the score we're seeing this early.
Yes.
I have people tell me you're going to see an ugly game in the 50s. Well, we may be seeing 50s at halftime.
Kentucky already with 47 points. Goodwin charging in. That won't drop. Cauley-Stein, that won't fall, but dunked in by Poythress.
That's what Poythress' strength is. He is so strong physically. You know, Willie Cauley-Stein, he doesn't realize, I don't think, how good he can be. I really do. That kid is going to be a special player.
And short. And that's how the first half will end, with Kentucky on top, 49-36. A lot more scoring than maybe we anticipated. How about the donut from Maryland off the bench? And Kentucky has outscored them on the bench 17-0.
The two guys that really came off the bench and have really been outstanding, Polson and Willie Cauley-Stein. They have been really outstanding.
We'll be back with a halftime report in just a moment. 49-36, Kentucky. After the first 20 minutes, 49-36 over Maryland. Kentucky shooting 58% in the first half. Dick Vitale, your thoughts on the first half?
Well, I thought the defensive effort of Kentucky was absolutely superb. When you think about the fact that perimeter defense, they shut Maryland out 0-for-11 from the trifecta, and they shoot 29% when you look at the two-point range. They got to start making some threes. On the other side, you look at Kentucky. I thought Wiltjer offensively gave them a big lift. Goodwin certainly scored, attacking the basket, and they shared the basketball so well. I can't say enough about the play of Polson and Willie Cauley-Stein coming off the bench. Both guys were productive. Polson played a lot of minutes and didn't have a turnover.
Yep, surprisingly. A look at our Reese's perfect play. You talked about Wiltjer and how effective he was from three-point land.
Yeah, he really can. If you let him square up like that, playing the game of horse, man, he'll make that all day. I mean, you can't give him that open look. What impressed me is his ability to put the ball on the floor, and he made a great pass on the interior. Their interior passing has been really outstanding.
He was 3-for-4 from the three-point line. Kentucky 5-for-7 as a team. As Dick mentioned, Maryland did not hit a three-pointer. They were 0-for-11, but Alex Lynn kept them in it.
Yeah, Lynn is a guy with a lot of good skills for a seven-footer. They got to get some play out of guys like Wells, Howard, and Faust got to step it up in Padgett. The next 5 minutes are vital, vital for Maryland. I think Maryland's got to go on a spurt right here to get themselves a little confidence to get back in the game. On the other side, look at Kentucky. Noel didn't play a lot of minutes. He got two fouls, and he was on the sideline.
Well, Maryland has won 10 straight season openers. Last time they lost one was to Arizona way back in 2001.
You know, Harold played 5 minutes in the first half. There were reports about his flu. Noel played a total of 8 minutes in the first half.
Some suggested that Calipari had been riding Harrell so hard during the week, he was really on him. That's the reason he wasn't feeling too good.
I tell you one thing, he'll ride you, and that's because he thinks you can be a player.
Now Kentucky opening up with a basketball in the second half and with the lead. Poythress threading his way in for the stop.
Talked about it earlier. We didn't see the real Alex Poythress yet. That is the real Alex Poythress, the ability to get to the rack. I mean, it's unbelievable what they got coming in next year, and they're still in a hunt for two of the best players in the country, Randall and Wiggins, who people are saying right up there with Jamari Parker.
That's what, 4 years in a row, the number one or number two ranked recruiting class in America. Wiltjer there for the rebound off the Lynn misfire. He didn't miss many in the first half.
See, I think the play of Polson now gets a little bit more out of Harrell. You want to get minutes, you got to perform. Competition is the key. Fight for minutes.
Goodwin over the shoulder give for Wiltjer, and not there this time from the three-point line.
He shot that a little too quickly. Defensive player was right in his hand. Didn't have the real good open look.
Howard blocked from behind. Harrell got a hand on it.
They pride themselves defensively. That is the strength of a John Calipari team. Get athletes, number one. Get talent, obviously. Can't win without talent. The Wizard of Westwood showed that. He won because he had great talent, but he also had great coaching ability to get that talent to play as a unit.
Arrow fires a long one. That won't drop. He transferred from NC State, sat out last year. Now the lead at point guard, at least for the moment, and a nice drive here. 2 points for Faust, who needs a hot start.
He's a real good athlete. He can get up and down the floor, transition. I'm going to tell you one thing. Maryland's not going to see the kind of size they're facing with that kind of talent on a regular basis.
Back for Wiltjer. Arrow in the corner. Wiltjer trying to spin to his right, stumbles a bit, and he walked with it.
Yeah, out of control right there, down in that post. Watch Faust right now in transition. There's that speed, that athleticism, and get to the goal. Sign of a great coach like the Wizard of Westwood, John Wooden was, and you think of the great ones out there today, Mike Krzyzewski, Roy Williams. They get great players to play as a unit. Understand what a good shot is, understand how to defend as a team.
Deswell swooping in, that won't drop. Wells named to the Atlantic 10 all-rookie team last year for Xavier. Poythress driving again, and a foul. That will go against Maryland with 17:37 to go.
I think we're going to see Poitras put a lot of points on the board in his career for Kentucky, joining Goodwin. I think those two guys are going to be their two big scorers.
Poythress going to the line. He scored 25 points in the blue-white scrimmage for Kentucky. 6'7", about 240, really put together.
Great attitude. He just has to get that mentality, that toughness, the Michael Kidd-Gilchrist toughness, the warrior kind of ability. And John Calipari, if somebody can get that out of you, he can. He's tenacious and relentless in terms of every day with his players.
Wiltjer kept that rebound alive and back for Kentucky, leading at 51-38 in the early moments of the second half. Goodwin to his right. Nice pass and a stuff by Noel.
Great look right there by Goodwin. Finds Noel. Remember this, people. You're seeing this kind of rhythm and togetherness and that kind of passing. And we're in November. We're in November. Do you think they're going to be better come March?
Maybe just a little bit. Padgett whirling in, but he draws the foul. A 17-10 left.
I love seeing kids play as a unit. I love seeing kids that are unselfish, that are all about the team. All about playing as a unit, and that's what you're seeing right there. That brings a lot of joy to the coaching staff.
Wiltjer picked up his third. Padgett to the line. A senior, and as mentioned, a Brooklyn native.
Played at Lincoln High School. I believe that's the same high school as Stephon Marbury played too.
Wiltjer will step out with the three, and indeed, Padgett leading Lincoln to an unprecedented four straight New York City championships. And they starred in the final, which was played at Madison Square Garden. Now the pressure on the top and picked off.
Very sloppy, but you got to convert this thing. You made the steal. You got to get a deuce out of it.
Cauley-Stein got his hand on it and up and in. They finally do convert.
I'd go after him again. I would go after him again. A little bit out of control.
Goodwin finds Mays. Archie Goodwin, just a freshman on a very, very young but gifted Kentucky team. That's been said before.
He's playing point guard now. Got some point guard skills as well.
Mays off the fake, a leaner, no foul. Rebound picked off by Maryland. No whistle on that play. Tip from behind. Noel, the guy in transition, who got his hand on it from behind.
They do a great job with that deflection coming from behind in transition.
Goodwin denied and out of play. Knocked away by Maryland with 16:26 left.
Should have been a foul right there. They missed that call. Should have been a foul right there. They do a great job with that deflection. Coming from behind. That really is a great asset to have.
No foul on Len a moment ago, but his second block shot. He was one of the best shot blockers in the ACC last year. He was third in ACC games in that category.
Tell you, Anthony Davis was a shot blocker because he could go out and get three-point shooters. He had that lengthy ability to cover the whole floor.
Noel trying to feed it, slapped away by Maryland. Loose ball, and now play is getting sloppy. It'll go the other way. 16:18 left.
Only chance Maryland has to win this game, they have to make some for it. Somebody's got to step up. I thought the kid that was going to make the three for them is Aaron Hall. He came out of Albany. He's a transfer, had a great, great reputation shooting the ball there. Got a couple of minutes in the first half.
Cauley-Stein, very impressive in the first half, frankly, on both ends of the floor.
He gave him presence. He gave him that great size and that presence.
Tried to bank, not there for him. Len on the outlet. Here's Howard, Pishon Howard.
Pishon's had a little struggle offensively. He's got a lot of talent coming off an ACL injury.
Yeah, it was just cleared to practice in October. He lost that one up, and it's in and out. Another loose ball. Comes back to Maryland. Wells went for the stuff. Airborne, no foul there. Maybe a little bit of contact. He goes sailing into the crowd. He saved it. Padgett in tight. And a whistle and a foul.
Fantastic.
And a marvelous save, Dick, by Wells. He is now getting out of the stands.
Fantastic hustle by Maryland. Wells with a terrific hustle going into the crowd. And Maryland staying after it. Really playing hard. They got it down to 11, man. They are playing hard. They're not going to go away. They reflect their coach. He was a fighter and a scrapper who got the most out of his ability at Kansas.
Center, home of the Brooklyn Nets. Jay-Z opened it up with a concert on September 28th. He played for eight nights. Brooklyn's first arena of any kind since 1968. Seats 18,000 for a basketball game. It's in New York's. And there he is tonight. Brooklyn's first arena since the 1950s.
Hey, Jay-Z, what an entrepreneur he has become. Unbelievable. Hey, Brooklyn, you got to get Neil Diamond here for a concert. Neil's from Brooklyn as well.
Padgett at the line. Poythress fouling him for his third personal moments ago.
This Maryland team is not going to go away. They're going to keep scrapping and clawing. They got to make some shots. They need somebody to make some. Go get Albert King. He'll make some shots for them.
That's a 6-0 run here. 53-44.
Let's look at Albert. You know, Padgett. They won four city titles. His teammate, Lance Stevenson, now doing a job with the Indiana Pacers. There's a full court pressure.
Cauley-Stein gets it off the Mays to break it.
Nice job by Willie Cauley-Stein to step up and need a release man, a little pressure. They're playing the big guys together now, the Twin Towers. Playing Noel and.
Noel, a little bit of foul trouble Dick in the first half. Picked up two quick ones. Harrell on the baseline. That won't roll in.
Nice little two-man play. Harrell doesn't convert. Played in North Carolina State. What a team they got down there. C.J. Leslie and company.
Alex Len with a double-double. The teardrop will fall in. 2 points for Howard. You were calling him to get a little offense going, and he has started to.
Here come the Terps, baby. It's down to 7. These young kids are going to get tested right now.
An 8-0 run for Maryland.
Kentucky a little bit stagnant. Orfitt's not getting much movement.
Mays hit the floor. No foul there. And out it goes. Back over to Maryland.
Good defensive effort by Maryland. A little bounce in their step. A little confidence right now. That's all Turgeon, Jim. You got to give the coach a lot of credit. He kept fighting and clawing on that sideline. Making him come after him, believe. They got some strength. They got some good athletes up there. Mitchell's a big-time wide body.
Underneath Len for two more. Give him 18 along with 10 rebounds.
Nice little screen across the lane. Flash to the ball. He's having a heck of a first game. Alex Len.
It's a 10-0 run. And a foul here to go against Maryland with 14:10 to go. Trying to hold up the drive, but a nice give to Len in the finish.
He did a great job flashing to the basketball. Kentucky doesn't beat him across the lane. You got to beat that guy to the basketball. There's going to be a little concern on that Kentucky bench right now. Has to be concerned.
Len with his second foul. Harrell gave up the dribble. He's traveling with it.
He's going to get him out. He's going to get him out. He will not tolerate it. He's going to get him out. Here comes Polson.
Calipari telling him, you've got to talk. You've got to talk. 14:03 to go. Out he comes.
They missed a score, and a Wiltjer now sitting on a bench.
And Kentucky with five turnovers in the first half, Dick. Five already in the second half. Jake Lehman, a freshman. Here's Allen. Seth Allen. Boy, is he quick. He lofts that one up. The left-hander can't get it. Lehman went up high for the rebound. Comes free. They win it back again.
They're beating him on the glass. They're really dominating Kentucky on the glass.
Foul shot was in and out. Another loose one. It's Mitchell again. And a whistle.
If you're John Calipari, you cannot be happy with the second or third efforts that are really being exerted by Maryland. They're out scrapping, out hustling Kentucky right now.
Mitchell picked up the foul, the offensive. But Maryland certainly has the momentum in a big way here with over 13 minutes to play.
Well, you look at the rebound totals. They got a double-figure lead on the glass against the Cats.
Now you said during the commercial break, this game is a long, long way from over.
I told you that when it was down 12, didn't I?
Yes.
Oh, what did I say it on the air? Thanks, Dave. Thanks, Dave. I whispered to my guy, I said, Dave, this game is not over.
You did.
You can see it, the bouncing. Right now, it looks like Kentucky's struggling trying to get something going.
Polson back up running the point. 15 on the shot clock for the Wildcats. Mays wants to get it to Noel. He swings it out. Polson is open, but he can't drain it. Poythress with the rebound. Knocked away by Lehman. Quick hands.
Lehman really active. He's a guy who could step out and make shots.
He called for the ball. Couldn't get it to go down, however. Another rebound. Another second effort by Maryland.
It's unbelievable. I cannot believe that they're getting so many second shots.
Allen, quick step. Kentucky up by five.
They should get a post-up move inside for Poythress. I'd get Poythress some touches.
A timeout here. Faust is a little bit shaken up. And an official timeout with 12:31 to go. As he limps away, Nick Faust, who has been very aggressive at the point for the Terrapins tonight for Mark Turgeon.
There were spurts in that first half where Kentucky was sensational. Interior passing, moving the ball, making the threes by Wiltjer, defending.
Well, no turnover. The crowd howling for one there.
I thought it was a backcourt violation.
Yes, that's what everybody else thought.
Something that we didn't see, that the refs. Oh, yeah, it's a double dribble.
Yep, that time turned it over with 12:16 to go.
Double dribble right there.
A Tuesday on ESPN, it's the State Farm Champions Classic from the Georgia Dome. It's 7, Michigan State and Kansas. Then at 9, it's Duke against Kentucky for the first time in 10 years. That's Tuesday night.
You know, Duke's got some good, solid, big people. When you're talking about Plumlee, talking about Kelly.
Not bashful, it's a three.
He has that ability. He can step out and shoot a three. Brings a lot of energy, enthusiasm. Look at that joy and jubilation. The three will give you momentum. Uncle Mo is on the turf side right now, baby.
This, the first three-pointer Maryland has hit tonight. They had been 0-14, and the freshman knocks it down. From Maryland. And Dick Vitale, Kentucky has not scored a point in the last 5 minutes.
Great job defensively, being out hustled. Maryland really getting after the ball. Double figure lead and rebounding. John Calipari's got to be sweating. He'll start chewing that towel. All of the Jerry Tarkanian days.
Harrell breaking the press on the attack. The alley-oop off the fingertips of Noel. He could not convert.
Got to catch that and jam that, baby.
So Noel in foul trouble early, mishandles that alley-oop, should have been a dunk, and Kentucky clings to a two-point lead with 11:50 to go. John Calipari trying to find somebody to put the ball in the basket here over the last 5 or 6 minutes. Here's a look at the top 10 Associated Press coming into the season. Indiana rolled tonight.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Take a look at the top three right here. They're about 3 hours away from each other. I think it's fantastic for that area to have three heavyweight teams. Indiana, will see them in about 8-9 days. Should have a great year. My preseason player of the year, Cody Zeller. They just gave an extension to Tom Crean. And Louisville, 1-10. has as deep a team as there is in America. Arrow, their second five could probably be the top 25.
Arrow with the Mystic off the inbounds plane. On the other end, the slam by Clear. Shaq Clear. And this one is tied at 53.
Unbelievable. Look at the rebound, Jonas. It's almost a 3-to-1 ratio. Maryland over Kentucky on the offensive glass. 25-9.
And Goodwin with a mishandle off his foot, but they get it back.
They need Wiltjer to step up and make a shot. They've been getting nothing offensively. He has to make a shot.
And on cue, a three-pointer. He was listening. 56-53. That ends a 15-0 run and a scoreless streak of over 6 minutes for Kentucky.
I think Layman's going to be a really good player for them. He's got that bounce to him. That I love his energy. Comes from an athletic family.
He hit that three off the bench. Their first three, just a freshman. Wells can't get it to go in tight. Knocked away. Kentucky in transition. There's Layman to swat it away. Goodwin on the baseline. Tried to reverse a little too much.
Yeah, that's a bad, bad shot right there. But you know what?
He's called
a midcourt. Noel got fouled right here in half court.
No whistle.
No whistle.
Down the lane. The bank shot won't fall for Mitchell. Boy, it is fast and furious. Finally a foul. Noel is angry that there was no whistle at midcourt.
I mean, Dave, right in front of us right here. He got hammered. He got hammered.
Foul on Mitchell will be his second for Maryland.
They would throw the flag in the NFL. I mean, right here, bam! I mean, he got knocked out. What a block. I mean, he could play for the Jets right there because they're not blocking anybody. They could use somebody to block.
Noel, the 6'10 freshman.
Talk about overrated.
Boy, Wells is limping badly as he comes out of the game. Faust had already left the game previously, looking like he was in agony, although he's back in now. Well, you wonder if Des Wells is cramping up really badly in the first game of the season. 10-20 left. Kentucky with a three-point lead.
Got Harrell out of the game right now. Play amazing. Goodwin on the perimeter. See, Noel's limited offensively. That's why you say you can't compare him with Anthony Davis. He should be able to dunk around the basket. They want him to rebound and defend. He's not rebounding like he should here tonight.
Goodwin slammed by Lehman, who just picked up his third foul. So Des Wells getting treatment here. Let's take a look at him going down on the right part of your screen there. Right, number 32.
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, that was away from the play. So you'd assume it's a situation where he's cramping up. Goodwin at the line. Archie Goodwin, the freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas.
He just has to be in control a little bit more. Has a tendency a little bit out of control. But you don't want to really get him to where he's not going to do the thing he can do is get to the basket. So you talk to him about not being out of control, but you want to limit him.
Well, he has 14 points, missing that second foul shot. 57-53. Now the Terps had that long run. Let's see if they stay hot. Faust running the point. Alex Len, and he's held up and fouled on the baseline.
Okay, Alex is really tough for them to defend. He is really giving them the fits.
Third foul on Noel.
No, people, I feel in the Big Ten this year probably be the premier conference with the heavyweight teams they have, but they haven't won a national championship since 2000. You know, somebody asked me, how do you compare the Big Ten with the SEC in football? Well, the SEC in football has won 6 consecutive national championships. You got to win some national championships before we can compare them to the SEC and what they've done in football.
Michigan State lost in Germany earlier tonight to Connecticut.
Great win for Kevin Ollie in his first game. Strong perimeter for Connecticut, a little limited inside, but that's a real solid win for Kevin Allen.
That should get him a multi-year contract.
Yep.
Coming up on 9.5 to play, Faust. Len already has a double-double, can't add to that. And here comes Kentucky. 4-point lead for the Cats, ranked number 3 in the country. The NCAA's all-time winningest program, 2,090 wins.
Give it to Poythress. Give it to him inside. Let him attack the basket.
Trying to get in close off the fakes. Len shoved it right back at him. That's his third block. Howard gives it up. The long jump shot. Three-pointer for Allen. Seth Allen, another freshman, with a dagger off the bench.
Yeah, Allen makes that three, and Albert King jumps with joy. He's been rubbing it in. Every time they score, he goes and points toward Jay-Z, because Jay-Z's out there rooting for his guy, Calipari.
So Maryland had been 0 for 14 from three. They've made their last two. They're also getting inside here in the second half there.
I tell you one thing, Allen and Lehman are going to really help them. There they are attacking Kentucky, taking the ball right to the interior, right at their big guys, using their strength around the basket. They got a lot of strong physical players. This Maryland team's going to win their share of games in the ACC. There's definitely improvement. New Curtain fans are going to have a lot to love.
Now, last year in the conference, just 6-10. They would appear to be a lot better than that this year. Mark Turgeon now in his second year. And Scott Spinelli, who's a terrific assistant, has done a great job recruiting. You know, one area where Maryland's getting a lot of props, they're really sinking their teeth recruiting-wise into the state of Maryland going into next season.
They really have done a great job. They really, right there, lost out on the Harrison kids. But they keep going at it.
Now Spinelli, one of the outstanding young coaches in college basketball today. More pressure now from the Terps. Kentucky, 3-for-15 shooting since halftime. Goodwin driving to his right, held up and fouled, 8:41 to go. And that person will go on Faust, his first. So Kentucky's Goodwin to check it in. Seeing a lot of freshmen on both sides getting big minutes in this one. In the season opener.
You know, it's happening right now in college basketball. We're just in a transition.
Here's Harrell. Can't bury that around and out. Len with another tough rebound. Deshaun Howard around the back.
Wide open.
Allen again. Maryland.
I tell you one thing. Allen brings in a lot of spirit, as does Lehman. Making shots. He's going to earn PT. There'll be some hugs on that Maryland bench. Look at Albert King. He's a cheerleader. Look at Albert King. He's leading the crowd in cheers. Oh, he loves his Terps. Look at Albert. Look at him right here. One of the great Maryland players. I love that. Seeing that energy, enthusiasm. You know, they wear Under Armour. The former football star down there at Maryland. Captain Kevin Plank is the CEO. And he developed that Under Armour, started in his grandmother's cellar, and has made them to where they are today. And he loves his Terps.
Well, Seth Allen, the lefty, coming off the bench and draining two big threes. And this is the first lead for Maryland since the score was 9-7.
Cats are in a battle in game one, and it's not going to get any easier on Tuesday night when they face the Duke Blue Devils and Mason Plumlee and company. Maryland picked sixth in the conference preseason. I feel they're going to be better than this. I really do. I mean, you got North Carolina State, Duke, and Carolina. And then after that, it's right up a Florida State got shocked tonight. They got beat by, I believe, South Alabama.
The South Alabama. And FSU came in as a top 25 team, and they lose immediately.
And we have not seen the real Desmond Wells. Trust me, he's much better than what you've seen out here tonight. Lehman and Allen have given him a big lift.
Well, they certainly have, and Howard's playing much better in the second half. Very much in control. Olsen outside. Shot clock at 12. Wiltjer. Low, can't swing it in.
Uncle Mo is definitely on the side right now, Maryland, executing, really attacking the rim. I think the difference has kept him in the game. Look at this two-man play right here.
Back to Padgett. Oh, it was there for him, and it won't go down, but a whistle on the play.
Padgett should have dunked that. Should have dunked it.
Foul will go against Maryland.
That's a four-point turnaround in the way, because you have the deuce there. An easy deuce, you go up four.
Maryland right now by two as we come down the stretch. Well, the journey to the tourney. Most NCAA tournament titles, of course, all time. That honor is UCLA with 11, but Kentucky now at 8 after last season.
I love a few more during the run of John Calipari, but let me tell you this. Maryland's had 25 offensive rebounds that have led to 18 more shots. They have dominated Kentucky on the glass, and that's why they are leading right now and came back from a deficit of 15. Kentucky has 3 field goals in 12 minutes here in the second half.
Well, another big factor is the way Maryland's bench has stepped up. They were outscored in the first half 17-0 by Kentucky. They are outscoring Kentucky 11-0 in the second half.
Mark Turgeon jumping before the game, so I don't even know who's going to start. He said, because basically we got like 10 players. There's Wiltjer. Here's the big turnaround. Padgett has a dunk to put him up 4. Instead, they don't get the score. They foul, and it goes up here. Which could have been a 4-point turnaround if he converts that.
1 of 2 for Wiltjer. 1-point lead for the Terps.
Now you get down to the time of the game where shot selection becomes vital. Understanding who the best players are in terms you'd like to be your number one option. And that's certainly a Maryland option.
Len out to Allen. He's had the hot hand. Wells up top. 15 to shoot now. Len is 18 and 11. Trying to get around Cauley-Stein. And foul on the play with 7:14 left. That'll be number 2 on the big fellow.
You know, I talked to Desmond Wells before. And I said, Desmond, you played on an outstanding team last year at Xavier. How would you compare this Maryland team at this moment since you've been at practice with the talent level you had at Xavier? He said, we're going to be good here. We're going to be very good. He said, but that team was pretty good. He said, I played on Mark Lyons now, transfers up in Arizona.
Wells tied up. Great job by Mays to step in and tie him up on the play. Possession arrow will stay on this end of the court, but Mays with a defensive stop there.
Yeah, defensive stop, but he gets penalized because of an arrow. An arrow. I can't understand our rule makers. I've been screaming this for I don't know how many years. Here's another perfect example in a game situation. Kid makes a good defensive effort, and the arrow says, will we stay there? Ridiculous. Totally ridiculous.
Allen again. Rebounded by Noel, who is back in as Cauley-Stein has gone to the bench for Calipari. Under 7 minutes to go here in Brooklyn.
Noel's got to be a little bit more active offensively. Even though he's a limited judge of his skills offensively, with his length and size, he should get some offensive rebounds.
Goodwin off the spin, up off the window, and draws the foul.
I'm going to tell you one thing. He thinks degree of difficulty, he thinks we're in swimming, that you get more point totals for degree of difficulty.
Len with his second foul to put Goodwin at the line.
Archie Goodwin, 2 shots.
So 2 for Archie Goodwin, who is 7 out of 9 at the line. So he is getting to the line, and he's making them.
Now, people were yelling at me when I walked out. Kentucky fans, blowout city, baby, blowout city. No blowout city. I said this would not be Cupcake City, this Maryland team. I'm going to pull a little Brett Musburger here. I never used to look at spreads. I love my guy Brett. Brett would say, hey, they're a 16-point favorite, man. 16-point favorite.
17,732 in the building tonight. It's a sellout at Barclays Center.
Great for college basketball this area.
It got inside, and Len finished it up for 2 more.
Len got the best of Noel down in the post right there. He took advantage of him. Big fella didn't have good post position.
Alex Len has had a really fine night now. 20 points. He leads all scorers. The game has been tied 4 times. 7 times that lead has changed hands.
And Len playing man-to-man right on Noel. Noel's just standing. Easy to guard a guy when he doesn't move.
Kentucky trying to retake the lead. Wiltjer. Wants it again. Give him 2 more.
I'll tell you one thing. Wiltjer's becoming their go-to guy. Here's a guy that had hardly any minutes last year. He is really wants the ball. So get me the rock. Get me the rock. And he's converting with his back to the basket, not just shooting the 3.
17 points for Kyle Wiltjer. Des Wells got off the pass, and it's dropped in for 2 by Charles Mitchell, the freshman.
Look at that big wide body. He's got a Charles Barkley body. I want to do a game with Sir Charles, the round man of rebound. You told Richard Deitch in Sports Illustrated, I want to do a game with Dickie V. Let's get it done.
63-62. 5:15 left. Noel this time. Great spin, but too close. Polson with the follow.
Look at Polson. Good second effort. And that was a good move by Noel. At least he attacked the rim. Polson has been a surprise. I don't think many people thought he'd get this kind of time. Look at him. He's late in the game on the floor.
Heavy minutes.
Talking about playing the try. That was a walk-on.
I just committed the foul. Reaching in with 4:54 to go. His first.
And look at Polson.
With that foul, the man on the spot with that follow.
He's the trail guy. You know, obviously the Kentucky team last year was a step above. I mean, they really were. Talent level, ability. Anthony Davis took them to another level. They had three players last year. The difference in this team than last year, they had three quality players returning that helped life make a little easier for the freshmen. Terrence Jones, Darius Miller, and Lamb. Those are three NBA players that have come back. They don't have that this year. They don't have that at all.
Clear set the screen. Faust lets fly. Off the back iron. Rebound tipped. Yanked in by Mitchell. He's giving them some big possessions here. Wells can't get it to go. It's loose again. Another mad scramble. And a whistle with 4:25 left.
They are just beating Kentucky to the basketball. Flat out beating them. I mean, the rebound margin is absolutely a joke.
So 4:25 remaining. Kentucky up by one. 64-63.
Tell you one thing, people better come to play against Maryland the way they are tenacious on that glass. And he's got 10 players he can rotate.
A clear committed the foul. And Cauley-Stein will be at the line to shoot. We talked about his wide receiver skills at 7 feet tall in high school, and he can also run tremendously well. He said, I didn't get hit a lot.
Tell you one thing, throw the ball up high to him, you got yourself a score.
You betcha.
Look at those long, long arms.
Now Calipari said he was stunned, and the staff was stunned at just how good he looked this summer. As that one is knocked out of play, it'll be Maryland ball, 4:23 left.
They're going to be a real project, but he's a guy that's got a heck of a future. He's got to have develop some confidence and just keep working and working and working and listen to that coaching staff.
Howard across midcourt.
Pretty strong physically when you look at Maryland, their bodies.
Well, Noel said a really good job there as he went backward on it, but blocked. And the offensive foul will be on Wells, his second.
Gonna watch Desmond Wells right now. Gonna try to attack the basket. Defense rotates over. Good job of closing off that driving angle. And he's outside that arc. If you're in New York, there is a secondary defender. You can't get the charge.
And 10 turnovers now for Kentucky, 8 for Maryland. 2-point lead for the Cats.
Big possessions. Now you start getting down there. Every possession's big.
Noel with the left hand and the foul.
Gonna have to convert on a free throw line.
Len with his third. 3:49 remaining. Kentucky clinging to the 2-point lead, and John Calipari working and sweating tonight here at Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Kentucky on top here, 65-63. It's been a tale of two halves, and Alex Len is having the best game of his college career.
He's at a career high. He's at 20 points. He's very effective on the inside. He's got stronger, but on about 30 pounds. He's a lot stronger. He's going to be tough to deal with in the ACC. Also has 11 rebounds. 20 points and 11 rebounds. Career high. Alex Len. Something tells me those numbers are even going to go bigger and bigger and bigger as the year progresses.
And a lot of that against the top recruit in America, Nerlens Noel, the 6'10 freshman. 9 out of 17 for Len, the 7-footer from Ukraine.
It's a different ball game. You took on a high school level versus the collegiate level. He dominated with the great size, Noel, on a high school level. Now he's going to have to face the toughness and the size. And he has a real tough time on a free throw line. You can see it right there. Cauley-Stein and Mays in the first half at 13 points. Second half, they got a total of one. Kentucky's reeling right now. It's like a fighter that was dominating, and all of a sudden you're trying to hang on for the 14th and 15th round.
Well, they had a 15-point lead with 17 minutes to play.
But what a steal. Then,
and up and in for two.
What a great play by Polson. He's been the MVP for Kentucky because no one expected or anticipated this kind of effort. And he plays so hard. You could see Essence pride in wearing that jersey.
Loose ball, another scramble for it. Kentucky with a timeout.
What a terrific play by Polson. They're going to hug that kid. They're going to hug him. I mean, what a play he made on this end of the floor and a missed free throw by Noel.
Polson, a junior from Nicholsville, Kentucky, getting heavy minutes tonight.
You think as a kid he grew up dreaming of wearing a Kentucky uniform, a walk-on, a no-name, got all these big magical names, and here it is, in a moment on a big stage, he's become a star of stars. Here he is cutting without the ball. Here he is going to make the open shot. And now watch this off the tip, my friends. Pure hustle, fight, scrap. They're cheering down Alexis there. They say, wow, look at our little left-hander. He become a star now. Now he can't walk in the streets so much anymore. See, he was the one player who could walk out there. Nobody would ask for autographs. Now, right now, Jared, your life has changed.
Well, after you're done with him, he has no shot. Maryland, by the way, two turnovers all half before the last 15 seconds, and they've turned it over twice.
I have to go tell Matt Jones to talk about him on Kentucky Sports Radio. Get Jerry Tipton to write about him and Lexington Paper. What with John Clay? Get the guy some PR.
He has it now on the wing. Back out to Goodwin. Both teams with three timeouts remaining.
So many teams lose games at this time to get down to the last 4 minutes. They're trying to force that lob up to Noel, and it's not there. Telegraphed.
Now Maryland trying to recapture some momentum. Backed out by Allen. He hit two big threes in this one.
You know, Allen on the floor now late. See, I think this tells you what your coaches think about you when you're on the floor late in the game like this in a Mailox mashup.
Yep, first-year player. Loose ball. Mays picks it up. Kentucky to run.
There's the deflection again. Kentucky's done that well all night. Deflections from behind. Created the turnover.
Leading by four. 2.5 minutes to go here in Brooklyn in the season opener. Mays catches, fires. Rebound comes out high. Tip by Noel. Oh, he hit the deck. He caught it. He came up with it. Now a whistle. But a great play by Noel to keep that ball alive.
Yeah, he did a terrific job. Got his hand on the ball.
Padgett with his third foul.
You know, Polson played a total of 21 minutes all of last year. Played over 25 already. And I guarantee you, the 21 minutes, I don't know this for a fact, but I guarantee you that they were probably in mop-up time in blowout city. See, that could be a problem for Kentucky late in the game. When you got Willie Cauley-Stein on the line and you get Noel on the line, both big guys, you could see the way they release the ball. They struggle on a free throw line.
And Kentucky as a team is only 13 for 23 from the line tonight.
And most of those that were effective came from Goodwin. Right, right there, one out of two.
Poythress will return now for Calipari. And Polson, to much cheers from the Kentucky faithful. And of course, they always travel.
They have the most passionate fans in America, bar none. They have the most passionate, loyal fans. They absolutely adore and love Kentucky basketball.
Mitchell back on top for Wells, and now Allen will set it up, coming up on 2 minutes to go. Driving the lane. That won't fall, but tipped up and in by Mitchell.
There's the offensive glass again. The freshman with the tip in. I mean, look at the offensive boards. 27 offensive rebounds. Playing the freshman late in the game. You got Allen on the floor. You got Mitchell on the floor.
Kentucky with a timeout with a minute 46 to go. And leading by three, a timeout for the Cats. And Mitchell, the freshman, playing some big minutes here and made a big play.
Mitchell ripped wide body around that basket. Big, strong, physical with the tip. I'll tell you this, the thing that has shocked me the most here tonight, has flat out shocked me, is the domination of Maryland on the glass against the size. You talk about Noel, Wiltjer, you talk about Willie Cauley-Stein. I mean, it's been embarrassing and humiliating that's kept them in the game. That has given them respectability and a chance to win.
We got a lot of young players on both sides, so some of that, I guess, is expected. But what do you see down the stretch? Who would have the better grip on winning a close game?
Well, you know, right now, you look at Kentucky, I think that the fact that these kids have been so taught about what it is to win, about the fact of representing Kentucky, that'll be tough to beat, I really believe, in close games. I really feel that. Even though Maryland's going to win their share of basketball games, the Kentucky kids, they play with that unbelievable love of that jersey. That is so special. And they're going to take everybody's best hit, as Duke does, as Carolina does.
Well, I've seen tremendous heart out of Maryland here tonight, coming from 15 down. They grab the lead for a spell. Now Kentucky with the ball again. Goodwin, that's a traveling violation. Back over to Maryland it goes.
He is out of control. They're going to really have a little dilemma keeping him under wraps, yet not negating his ability to get up and down the floor.
Because there's no denying his great talent there.
Absolutely, super talent. So they're going offense, defense right now. Wiltjer comes in, he's out rather, and they bring Willie Cauley-Stein in for size. Harrell not getting minutes late in the game.
So under a minute and a half to go. Coming up next on ESPN, the Jazz and the Nuggets. We'll turn it over to the NBA after getting the college season started with a bang here tonight. Howard down the lane, a teardrop shot, that won't drop. A fight for the rebound, it comes away to Kentucky.
See, right now, I'd try to put Willie Cauley-Stein on the line or Noel. I would try to put them on the line. I'll let him kill a lot of time. They're trying to spread the court. Manage the clock. Spreading the floor. Get some movement.
Archie Goodwin off to Mays. Shot clock down to 10 now, Dick.
Mays can make free throws.
He drives it. No. Noel tried to tip in. No. Mays on the baseline. Batted away. Len with another block. He has four. Wells down the lane. No, he can't convert, but a foul with 39.7 to go.
Can't teach what Desmond Wells did right there. His transition ability.
A big block on the other end to ignite that transition.
Terps really scrapping and clawing as the block shot. What a game Len has had. Unbelievable game. And now you're going to watch Desmond Wells. There's that athletic ability. Doesn't get the conversion, but goes to the line. They're going to love him at Maryland. They're going to absolutely love his ability.
And he drops in the first one. The foul is on Poythress, his fourth.
My buddy in the house here tonight, Derek Wittenberg, former North Carolina State guard, played for Jimmy Valvano, coach, works with us at ESPN. He said he watched Maryland practice. He said, Dick, Desmond Wells is a pro.
6'5 sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina. Missed the second one, tipped out. Mishandled for a moment by Mays, but Kentucky fortunate to get it back. 68-66.
It's interesting. Who would have ever thought Polson on the floor with the ball in his hands late in the game? They're spreading the court. The Wiltjer is the one guy you don't want to put on the line.
Mitchell with the foul. And Wiltjer, an 82% foul shooter last season, will go to the line.
See, I think players have to know strengths, weaknesses of players. You got to know who the guys that can make free throws, the guys that can't make free throws. That's a difference in winning and losing.
Well, Maryland takes a timeout. Kentucky has one left, and the Terps left with two with 24.6 seconds to go. Earlier tonight in Germany, Connecticut surprised Michigan State. Michigan State going in a top 15 opponent, and Connecticut won that game right in front of our game.
Yeah, really a good game. You had Dan Schulman and our guys on the coverage, Dave Millis. I tell you this, you know, you talk about right now coming down the wire, making free throws becomes so big in the club. It's like special teams in football. You must convert. I'm going to tell you, a team that's going to be good, I just saw their score flashed on the board. Gonzaga, Mark Few's going to have a dynamite team in that backcourt. They can shoot threes, Pangos and Bell. and one of my premier best backcourts. I'm going to put it up. I just put it up on Twitter. You go to Twitter/GDV. So my best backcourts or my best frontcourts. Look at Jay-Z. A little nervous right now for his buddy John Calipari. I don't think he has any dilemma financially in his life to worry about a meal. I don't think he'll ever worry about a meal.
I'm not concerned about Jay-Z at this point. By the way, that was the sixth foul, so Kentucky will have the ball, but 24.6 seconds to go. And Wiltjer, let's see if they've changed it. Posted six fouls. Wiltjer is at the line anticipating shooting here.
This is big, Dave. If he makes two, you don't have to go to Harvard to figure out you get a two-possession game. So the bottom line is these free throws become big. You can be an 82% shooter, but now you shoot it on a stage with pressure.
All right, so he will shoot here. 24.6 to go. And makes the first.
He's got a great stroke. He really does have a beautiful stroke. Great rotation. Good backspin. Keeps the elbow in.
18 points.
Great follow through.
And now 19 for Wiltjer.
That's a confidence boost for him.
So Kentucky leading by four with 24.6 to go.
You want to play good defense now. You don't want to foul.
Keyshawn Howard gives it up for Lehman. He can shoot the three. Knocked away into the backcourt. It was tipped.
It was deflected. It was deflected.
On the drive baseline. Swings it to Lennon. Close and fouled in the act of shooting. He'll go to the line.
See, that's a major mistake. You foul, you stop the clock, you allow a good shooter to go to the line, and now they can get set up into their defensive pressure. And their defensive pressure has bothered Kentucky a little bit. It's important he converts to here and get into that trap.
So Len, 21 points, a career high, also 11 rebounds and four blocks, has been just superb for Maryland tonight.
He has really improved, Dave. He really has gotten better and better and better. You can see that. Oh, that's a big miss. No, he came up with another offensive rebound in the conversion.
He lays it in.
I tell you, Kentucky all night long. Get a little Lionel Richie. All night long, beating them on a glass.
8.9 to go in a two-point game.
I mean, you can't let a guy come up and get this offensive rebound. You got to block out. Nobody blocks out. Put a breakdown. Got down and Wiltjer blocked out. And nobody got the shooter.
So Len converts. And 70-69. With 8.9 left.
If that ball is touched on the floor by Noel, you got to put him on the line.
Well, he has shown, obviously, that he is going to struggle at the foul line, at least initially in his college career. There's your reset.
No, he's not on the floor. Oh, he's not on the floor. But I would do the same with Willie Cauley-Stein as well.
So Maryland to press. This has been an effective press tonight.
Yeah, it really is. Very active athletically.
Polson tied up and fouled by Faust. 7.7 to go. Both teams with one timeout left. It.
Who would have thought Polson would be the guy on the line who can sort of give them that little bit of a lead in terms of making it a lot tougher for Maryland if he converts two. Then you're looking at a three to try to tie the game. He's a kid that we didn't anticipate playing a lot at all tonight.
He's played very effectively coming off the bench for Calipari.
When I spoke to the coaching staff, they gave me players. They never gave me this kid. Tell you one thing, he is earning some PT tonight.
Boy, is he ever, and very confident with that first one to make it 71-69.
Smart move now, bringing Noel in for defense. Possibly for an offensive rebound. It's beautiful to see kids earn playing time. Not a big reputation, but here he is, the star tonight. Boy, for them.
Two huge foul shots there by Jared Polson, a former walk-on. to make it 72-69.
See, I don't allow Maryland to shoot the three. I think that right now, you let them take a little time off the clock, get the ball up the court, and then you foul and don't let them shoot the three. That's my way of doing things. Now, I may be wrong. There's different philosophies. I really believe you don't let him shoot the three.
What do you think Calipari will do?
I think he believes in defense, and I think he'll just challenge and say challenge the shot. I'm not convinced he will go for the foul. I know my late buddy Jimmy V would have definitely went for the foul.
Remember, Mario Chalmers, Kansas, hit a three to beat him.
Exactly.
In a national championship game. Yeah.
Should have fouled there. Hey, what about right now to where Maryland's on the glass? Kentucky better be really alert in an offensive rebound. But they need a three. Any way you cut it, they need a three. Even an offensive rebound, they're going to kick it out to somebody for a three.
So the Terps with the ball, 7.7 to go.
They brought Aaron Holm on the floor.
Both Cauley-Stein and Noel in the ball game here for Kentucky, the bigs.
Aaron Holt is a three-point shooter, specialist number two. They just put him on the floor. They should have found him. He's wide open.
Howard into Noel, leading up, and can't get it to go. And that's how it ends. Kentucky with a 72-69 victory. They hold on for the win.
The kid Aaron Holt was wide open in the wing. And he's a noted three-point shooter, a transfer from out of Albany. Outstanding shooter, but never got his hands on the ball.
Pishon Howard went right into Noel, the 6'10 freshman.
Kentucky survives, and they want to thank and hug Mr. Polson. An unknown player has been a star of the moment for the Cats here tonight. Made a couple of big free throws, had a great offensive rebound, did turn the ball over.
Wound up with 10 points.
Played quality minutes. Big time performance by a kid who they didn't count on.
In the end, a defensive stop as Howard's shot goes off to the right side of the rim. 72-69, the final. Kentucky wins. And coming up next, it's Utah and Denver, all part of Kia NBA tip-off week. For Dick Vitale and our crew, we say goodnight. Now it's on to Denver, Colorado.